Glory be to the Lord's holy name. This morning we are allowed to have one of the, I don't say the most difficult, but almost I was spending 1 week to get this message ready. It's one of the simplest, it's one of the most difficult, it's one of the most important messages, sermons I'm going to share with you. A very simple caption, the vessel, the vessel. What does that word vessel mean? I was going through different dictionaries to get the exact and also the simplified meaning of the word vessel. So vessel has got 5 different but important meanings. If you want, you can make a note of it. Vessel, any of the tubular structure in the vascular system of a plant or an animal. Only through that vessel, water and the other nutrient go to the different parts of the plant, to the leaves, to the fruit, to the flowers, through these vessels. Through these vessels. So any of the tubular structure of the vascular system of a plant serving to conduct water and mineral nutrients from the root. Number 2, a tube that carries liquids such as blood through the body, the veins. We call it blood vessel. There's a blockage in the blood vessel. There is a blockage in the blood vessel. So it's that vascular system. Even it's very surprising, the word vessel comes from the word was. From that only what you study in your science, vascular system, where all our veins and all which carry veins which carry blood to different parts of our body and back to our heart, from heart to other parts of the body, from other parts of the body to heart. We call that as a vascular system. From that word was, that vascular system came, from that we get the word vessel. It's very surprising, something that carries. And the third meaning of that word vessel, a large boat or a ship. A large boat or a ship. A carrier. Not only a ship, even an aircraft which carries passengers or which carries cargo. We call that a vessel. And our Joe is from the Merchant Navy. We all use the word more ship, boat, etc. But I do believe the marine people, mostly they use the word vessel. That vessel is birth. Am I right, Joe? Yes. They use the word vessel. It's a vessel. So we understand vessel is something that is used to transport, to carry. So it may be a vascular system in a plant, or it may be a vascular system in a human body, or it may be a ship, a boat, or an aircraft that is used as a carrier of cargo, or carrier of passenger. And the fourth one, generally we call any container that holds liquid, we call it a vessel. A vessel in the kitchen, a vessel in the bathroom, a container, a bowl. We call that a vessel, a cooking vessel. A flower vase. From that only we get the word vase also, a flower vase. A vase. That word vase is called vessel. So a container. And the fourth and the fifth and the most important meaning, a vessel is a person who is used for a particular purpose. Vessel is a person, a vessel of the Lord. A vessel is a person used for a particular purpose is called a vessel. So the five meanings all come from the word was. Number one, it carries, it conducts, it's a conduit of water and the mineral nutrients from the root to the different parts of the plant. In a human body, it is the vessel, it's the vein, blood vessel that transmits blood from heart to different parts of the body, from different parts of the body back to the heart. So we say there's a blockage in the blood vessel. It's a vessel. And number three, a ship, a large boat or an aircraft that's used as a carrier. Number four, any utensil in our house, a container that holds a liquid is called a vessel. And the fifth one, the most important one, any person who is used for a purpose, he is a carrier. The vessel in botany is a carrier. The vessel in human body, it's a carrier. It transmits. It has got a purpose. A ship from one port to another port, it's a carrier. An aircraft from one port to another airport, it's a carrier. Now a person is called a vessel. A person is called a vessel. So this person is a carrier. He has got a purpose. So as the vessel in a plant takes the mineral nutrients and water through the root to different parts of the plant, similarly, a person chosen by God, a person chosen by a body, an organization, is a vessel. He has got that water, that mineral nutrients, that blood, and he has to conduct that to different parts. So that's why we call a person a vessel. Last week in the exhortation, the Spirit of the Lord constrained me to speak to the church about the vessels unto honor and the vessels unto dishonor. After the service, many people came and told me that was a great blessing to them. And also a person who was with us at the web streaming called me and said that the exhortation was a great blessing. Glory be to the Lord's holy name. From that time I was making a deep meditation on the vessel. Now see here, now I allow him to assist me. Now you see here I got two tumblers, two vessels. They are identical. They are not the same, but they are identical. Their physical properties are the same. Their shape is the same. The metal with which it is made is the same. The size is the same. And also the chemistry of these two tumblers may be the same. They are the same. I'm going to read to you one verse. If I got a copy of the Bible, kindly turn with me to Hebrews chapter 9. Hebrews chapter 9. We read verses 21 and 22. Moreover, he is sprinkled with blood both the tabernacle and all the vessels of the ministry. He is sprinkled with blood both the tabernacle and all the vessels of the ministry. And almost all things are by the law purged with blood. And without shedding of the blood is no remission. Without shedding of the blood, there is no remission. Now just I move here, so that would help me. I told you, these two vessels are identical. These two vessels are physically, they are almost the same. I am going to make one vessel different from another. I am going to make one vessel different from another. What they do, this vessel is going to be a vessel of ministry, a vessel that's going to be used for ministry, a divine purpose, a worship purpose. In Tamil we read Aradhanaikuriya Patram. In another translation in Tamil it says Irai Panikuriya Patram. Irai Panikuriya Patram. In one translation it says Valivattu Kalam. Both are the same, but I am going to make one that's used for the ministry. One is just for a secular. I can say one is for secular, one is for sacred. Why is this for secular? Maybe because in my left hand, I don't know. This is for sacred. Why is this for sacred? I don't know. Maybe it's because on my right hand. Okay? Now you take it as simple. I'm going to make one for a secular use. Just to drink water. It's just to drink water. I'm going to make this for sacred purpose. But they are the same. They are identical. Their physical properties are the same. Their chemical properties are the same. But one is going to be used for secular, one is going to be used for sacred. What do I do? How to make this usable for sacred? Now what I do, I take the basin. Come, come. He is my Levite, co-worker in this sanctification process. Now we are taking the basin. In the basin what we do, we are going to take some blood. Blood of the sacrificial lamb. We sacrificed the lamb and we have collected the blood. So we are taking the blood. Oh, this blood, we are taking the blood, that's right. And we add some holy water to that. We add some holy water to that. And there is a herb on either side of the rustic street, a type of a herb that is called hyssop. Somewhere, anywhere, everywhere it would be available. We take the bunch of hyssop. We take the bunch of hyssop. Just to make a brush. And very nice brush Brother Thambi Selvam has made. Very nice. I think that we can use it permanently. Okay. I soak this hyssop into that blood. Shall I sprinkle on you? He is scared now. I sprinkle on the vessel. Oh, more on my kurta. Selvam has promised me to get another new kurta, don't it? So I sprinkle. Now the viscosity of the blood is very thin, so you can't see that. Now this is, thank you, ma. Now this has made that difference. This has sprinkled with the blood. This is the vessel for ministry. This is the vessel for ministry. This is not sprinkled with the blood. So this is just for a secular, but both are the same. Both are identical. But because this is sprinkled with blood, this is made holy, and this is used for sacred purpose, the vessel of ministry. This doesn't have blood, so this can be used for secular purpose. Now please listen carefully. They don't have life. They don't have soul. They don't have spirit. They are only material. They are only material things, matter. They don't have spirit, they don't have soul. But this vessel, one is made for ministry, a vessel of ministry, one is made for secular purposes. Just the difference is brought by sprinkling of the blood of the sacrificial, not just any blood, blood of the sacrificial animal. Blood of the sacrificial animal. Now just imagine, come closer. These two are, almost identical. They are not the same. There could be some differences. But almost they are the same. They got a beautiful dress, tie, etc. They are almost the same. But the difference between these two vessels and these two persons, they got spirit, they got soul, they are human beings. They are not just made of some matter. Now we want to use, both are very good people, just for demonstration. We want to use one vessel as a vessel of ministry, a sacred vessel. One is a secular vessel. Now just imagine, we'll think that he is a secular vessel. He is a vessel for ministry. Okay, one is not saved, one is saved. Both are good in studies, both are good in sports, both are good in obedience to their parents. Both got a religion, maybe a Hindu or Muslim or a good Christian. They go to church, they pray, both are the same. But he doesn't have saved experience of salvation. He has got the experience of salvation. Both can play cricket. Both can sing. Both will have the same interests. Both physical structure are the same. Both chemistry may be the same. They are human beings. What all the interests he has got, the same interests he has got. The good nature he has got, he has got. The bad nature he has got, he has got. They are the same. Not the same, they are identical. But both are human beings. When the blood of Christ is sprinkled on him, both are same. When the blood of Christ is sprinkled on him, he becomes a sacred person. Can you see that? Those who understand, lift up your hands and praise God. Lift up your hands and praise God. When the blood of Jesus sprinkled on him, he becomes a sacred vessel. He's a good boy. But the blood of Jesus Christ is not sprinkled on him. He is a secular vessel. He is a secular person. Now when the blood of Jesus Christ sprinkled on him, his spirit is awakened. His thinking process is awakened. His desires change. His lifestyle changed. It's all because of the work of the blood in his spirit. It's not sprinkled on his body. The blood of Jesus Christ is not sprinkled on his body. It's in his spirit, in the inner man. That changes his attitude. But his physical properties are the same. His chemistry is the same. He also got all glands as he has got. He has got bones, he has got flesh, he has got nerves, he has got thinking process. He also got blood, he has also got flesh, he also got bones, thinking process. Everything would be the same. But he is sprinkled with blood of Jesus who died on the cross. He is not sprinkled. He has got a good religion, very religious boy. Every Friday he may go to the temple, or he may go to the mosque, or Sundays he would go to the church, Sunday school, VBS, etc., etc., religious. But blood is not sprinkled. He has got blood sprinkled in him. That made this vessel different from this vessel. Thank you. That changes their thinking process. They all got all the system the same. Both may be hungry. Both will be thirsty. Both can sing. Both will have, as they got all the other systems, they may have their reproductive systems. But their whole thinking process becomes different. One is the vessel of ministry. It's not only whether you're in the full-time ministry or part-time ministry. Aaradhanaikkuriya patram. We all are aaradhanaikkuriya patram. We must be different. We are different from our friends, our colleagues, our relatives, our classmates. Pastor Sundaram used to say, others me, but I cannot. others may, but I cannot. My thought process becomes different. What I think right is different. What I think wrong is different. Probably for your classmate, your college mate, dressing in a particular way may look very stylish, but the same thing will look very awkward for you. For you it looks awkward. I mean, I'm just openly saying, I've seen some men taking their wives with them. Almost the whole body is exposed. I don't know whom they want to see that body. For their mind, it's very stylish. Free, liberal, modern, their mindset. I don't say that woman is a bad woman. But the same thing for my mind, it looks awkward. See, our mind, the reason is because the blood is sprinkled. Because the blood is sprinkled. There's a husband and wife relationship. Whether the pride of the world, whatever it may be, our thinking process. Say for somebody, the other day somebody said, college padikirana, arias irundhaanda college padikirathu. Nada, arias illama oru padipa, avanudi thinking process. Fail at me. First varanum. Namma thinking process. There is a stop line, and you stop your vehicle behind the stop line. Your classmate is sitting at the back, your friend is sitting at the back. Eh, nada macha. Namari bayandangoli mari vandi nirthra. அவனுக்கு கோட்டுக்கு பின்னால நிறுத்தினா பயந்தாங்கோழி. அவன் மைண்ட் செட். தேர் இஸ் நோ படி, தேர் இஸ் நோ போலீஸ், நோ படி. யுவர் மைண்ட் செட், நோ நோ, ஐ திஸ் இஸ் ஸ்டாப் லைன், ஐ ஷுட் ஸ்டாப் பிஃபோர் தட். ஸோ வி ஆல் ஆர் சேம். பட் த டைம் த ஸ்பிரிட் ஆஃப் த லார்ட் ஸ்டார்டட் மூவிங் இன் அவர் ஹார்ட். வென் வி ரிசீவ் ஜீசஸ் கிரைஸ்ட், ஆர் வென் வி அக்செப்ட் Jesus, our propitiation, let the blood of Jesus sprinkled in our heart, in our spirit. That changes our thought process. Because there is a change in our thought process, there is a change in our behavior. Very briefly, I show you five things. How this vessel of the Lord must be. How this vessel of the Lord must be. Number one, Acts chapter 9 verse 15. But the Lord said unto Ananias, go thy way, for he is a chosen vessel. For Paul, it's a Saul. He is a chosen vessel unto me. It's a vessel chosen. It's a carrier. As in the spiritual vascular system. He is a vessel chosen unto me to bear my name as a vessel transmits blood. He is to bear the name of the Lord before the Gentiles and kings and the children of Israel. Now the Lord tells me, Simon Robert. We are both assignments, so I have to differentiate. So Simon Robert, you go to Simon Geo. I have chosen him. I have chosen him for a purpose. He has to bear my name, that Jesus is the Savior. Jesus is the Lord. Jesus is coming again. He has to bear my name to his Gentile friends. Other chartered accountants. Not only to the Gentile friends, I have chosen him to bear my name to the kings. Because he'll be going to different big business magnates to do the chartered accountancy. So the Lord says, I have chosen him to bear my name to the Gentiles, to the kings, and to Israel. Some of his relatives are Roman Catholics. Some of his relatives are Protestants. Some of his relatives may be nominal Pentecostals. So here the Lord says, I have chosen him. I have chosen. That's why Ananias came and the Brahma to tell him, I have chosen you. The Lord has chosen him with a purpose. So the vessel has got a purpose. He is a person chosen with a definite purpose. He has to bear the name of the Lord Jesus to the Gentiles. You got Gentile friends, am I right? To the kings, to big business people, to the company CEOs, proprietors. You are mixing with them. So he has to take the name of Jesus to them. And also to Israel, the people of God, but not personally knowing God. Like CSA, Roman Catholic, nominal Pentecostal, yoga relatives, your own people. So God has chosen him, with a purpose. That's a vessel. So number one, it is a chosen vessel. You have got a purpose. And from Genesis, we read about this God's choosings. God has chosen Abraham. Now we don't know why God has chosen Abraham. Why has God chosen Simon? We don't know. It's God's divine purpose. I remember many years back, the first ever sermon I preached in ACA about the ravens which brought food to Elijah. Why did God choose ravens? God could have chosen some peacocks. God could have chosen some cuckoo birds. God could have chosen some parrots. Why did, at least doves, eagles, why did God choose ravens? So I thought that we could go and ask ravens, why have God chosen you? God could have chosen beautiful peacocks. They could just go dance before Elijah. That could refresh him. Or God could have chosen some cuckoo birds. They could go and sing unto Elijah. Or God could have chosen eagle. At least Elijah could be proud. Eagles brought me food. At least dove, which was a symbol of holiness. Dove that can bring hope. God could have chosen dove. After all, why did God choose ravens? So he'll ask ravens, why did God choose you? Raven will have an answer. You know what will raven say? Ravens will say, ka, ka, ka. That's all ravens can say. Yeah? What else ravens can say? Yes. Only ravens can say that. It is grace. It's predestination. God has chosen on Mary. God has chosen on Simon. You are a chosen vessel. And you have got a purpose. The purpose is to carry the name. A ship will not go without a purpose. An aircraft will not fly without a purpose. So tomorrow you should not go to this college without a purpose. You are just like any other girl in that college. With the same type of blood, with the same type of desires, but you are a vessel for the Lord's work. The Lord has chosen you with a definite purpose. You can't be just like anybody else. So number one, I love to go a little faster. Number one, you are a chosen vessel. How have you been made different? Because of the sprinkling of the blood of Jesus in your spirit. That has influenced your soul. That has influenced your behavior. Number two. This is very, very important. In Hebrews chapter 9 verse 4. which are the golden censer and the Ark of the Covenant overlay. This speaks about the most holy place, the tabernacle, outer courts, holy place, and the most holy place. The most holy place had the golden censer. The most holy place had the Ark of the Covenant overlaid round about with gold. And wherein, within the Ark of Covenant, wherein was the golden pot or golden vessel that had manna, and Aaron's rod that budded, and the tables of the covenant. Now the second vessel is a golden vessel with manna in it. So there was a golden vessel that had manna. About this vessel alone, there are 7 points. I don't want to take time for those 7 points. It's a golden vessel. Gold speaks about glory. So this chosen vessel, Paul is a golden vessel. Peter, a golden vessel. Not an ordinary vessel. When you are chosen for the Lord's purpose, it is not the gold and silver of the world. It is the glory of the Lord. So you are a glorious Christian. And Paul was writing about his assistants. Paul says, if you ask me about Titus, he is the glory of the God. So if you ask me about the people those are helping me in the ministry, vessels of ministry, what must I be able to say? Simon is glory of God. Emil, glory of God. Selvam, glory of God. They are not ordinary vessels, they are golden vessels. And not only golden vessels with manna in it, not just ordinary golden vessels. Here in the ministry, vessel of ministry, you are used for divine purpose. So you are a golden vessel. But what is inside? Inside that golden vessel, manna. Manna speaks about the word of God. Manna speaks about God's provision. Manna speaks about faith life. Manna speaks about God's miracle in our life. I can go on and on. Manna means, what is this? So that heavenly manna, so I tell all you people, you are not ordinary vessel, you are golden vessel with manna in it. God's word in your life. You are just like other child in the college. He's like another chartered accountant in that company. How many chartered accountants are there in your company right now? Junior chartered accountants. Only or only junior. Okay. He's just imagine there are 5 chartered accountants, junior chartered accountants in that company, in that firm. He's one among them. But in the sight of God, he is a golden vessel. He is a golden vessel with manna in him. Other vessels may not have manna in them. But he has got the word of God. The word of God says, don't be conformed to the fashions of the world. That manna is in him. So he doesn't want to be conformed to the fashions of the world. Others may. But he is also living in the same place. He may also eat in the same canteen. He may also have coffee in the same tuck shop. But manna inside. Manna inside. The word of God inside. The word of God says, do this, don't do that. This is how you must have a hairstyle. Why? The word of God is in him. The word of God will be in Emil. The word of God may not be in the boy who is sitting next to him. So he is a vessel with manna in it. So Emil is a vessel with manna in it. The other boy may not have the word of God. He may be a good boy. He may have a religion. He may have his own way of worship. He may study good. I don't say he's a bad boy. But what makes Emil different from the other person? Emil has got the blood of Jesus sprinkled in him. So he has become sacred. That boy is not sacred. He's for secular purpose. He is for the world. Even he will understand religion, the way of the world. So when manna is inside, it means the word of God inside. How could a youth, a young man, keep his way pure except keeping the word of God within him? How can a young girl keep her pure except keeping the word of God in her? I got saved when I was 21 years old. I was able to keep my life holy because of the word of God in me. Because of the word of God in me. I don't say I am perfect. I got all my weaknesses, all my shortcomings. To make you understand, what all you can do, I can do. What all you can't do, I can't do. To a great extent. A normal chemistry. In a worldly sense, in my college days, I was a hockey player. And I was in St. George's, I was fresh from college. And if Joe could remember me, he could remember how I used to play hockey also. So normal physical structure. I was an intercollegiate secretary for a Tamil forum. I was playing chess. I could play table tennis, I could play basketball fairly well. Why do I say this? I'm not a goody-goody boy, I'm not a choplangi. It's not that I don't have a good physical structure or anything, or a weak boy or a sickly boy. I was a normal boy. Yet, manna was leading me. What others could do, I could not do. What others could do, I can do. But what others could do, I was not doing because of manna in me. Because manna in me. My parents were not with me. I had a very fat salary with me. I'm the youngest. I'm not bound to support my parents or my, there was no younger brother or sister that I have to support. There were girls around me, ladies. Except the eyes of the God, there was nothing that could stop me. Manna in me. In 21 years. So you are not just a chosen vessel, you must be a vessel with manna. It has got 7 points about it. It's a vessel with a golden vessel with manna in it. It is in the most holy place. Not only in the most holy place, it is within the Ark of Covenant. It has got manna inside and it is within the Ark of Covenant. And the mercy seat was covering it. It was under the mercy seat. And it was by the side of two things. One is the tablets where the law of God was written. The Ten Commandments were written. And on the other side, it is the Aaron's budding rod. It's all got deep meanings. But see where you are. Are you in the most holy place? In the presence of God? Where the eyes of the Lord are upon you? In the Ark of Covenant? Under the mercy seat? Think for a minute. It's not enough that you have a golden vessel. I love to show you a golden vessel. Don't be hurt. But I love to show you a golden vessel. Revelation chapter 17 verse 4. Revelation chapter 17 verse 4. And the woman, that woman speaks about a false religious system, the spirit of Babylon. And the woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet color and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, having a golden cup or a golden vessel in her hand. So the spirit of Babylon, that's a religious system, that was also holding a golden vessel in her hand, full of abominations and filthiness of her fornication. There are some golden vessels, vessels of ministry, filled with fornication, filled with worldliness, filled with abominations. They'll go for preaching. And I mean, it's all happening. There was a young preacher, I heard about him. I know him. At the time they were looking for a bride, wherever he used to go in those days, before his marriage, the message was how Eleazar found Rebecca. Any church he is called, எப்படி இல்லையா சார் பொன்பாக்க போனார் இவர் அங்கே சபைக்கு போயிருப்பார் பிரசங்கம் பண்ண ஒன் டே வென் யூ ஆர் டாக்கிங் டு மீ இஸ் அ ப்ரீச்சர் எ கோல்டன் வெஸ்டர் ஃபில்டு வித் ஃபார்னிகேஷன் வென் யூ ஆர் ஸ்பீக்கிங் டு மீ ஹீ சேட் சி பிரதர் ஐ மீன் வி ஆல் வேர் ஆல்மோஸ்ட் இஸ் லிட்டில் எல்டர் டு மீ பிரதர் ஏபிசிடி பார்த்து தாங்க பொண்ணு பார்க்கணும் நான் எப்படி கற்றுக்கிட்டேன் தேவ சித்தம் பார்த்து பொண்ணு பார்க்கணும் When pastor was giving this proposal, I had never seen her. We were in the same church, we were in the same Sunday school, same VBS, but I had never seen her. I know our pastor Ma's brother. When the pastor said, James will be a Thangachi, I don't know who was James Thangachi. I am in the presence of God, I am saying this. God is a witness. I don't care anything about what you people would say. But in the presence of God, I am saying. So what is God's will that should be done in my life? Nothing else. He told me, Brother, ABCD, paathaam ponnu paakkanum. I said, what is that ABCD? Kada 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 kada, 26 letters that man finished. A, age, B, beauty, C, caste, D, dowry, E, education, F, fairness, etc., 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 up to Z, he said. Thank God I remember only up to F. So he is also a golden vessel. He'll be standing and preaching, but filled with abomination. Can you see that? Filled with abomination. So you may be a vessel of ministry, but filled with manna or filled with abomination. What has filled you? There is a golden vessel that has got manna. There is another golden vessel that has got fornication. All the thoughts. So here we read about a golden vessel that is filled with adultery, filled with worldliness. So it is not enough that you are a golden vessel. You must be a golden vessel filled with manna. Not the way, because the blood of Jesus Christ is sprinkled in your life. So ministry, we can do it for two things. Ministry we can do is just to be a show off, just for others to see, just for the, what can I say, if I put it in ordinary Tamil, please forgive me, seen katradhuk. You can do the same ministry for the glory of God. whether it's preaching or singing or dancing, whatever the part of the ministry. It can be just for a show off, or it can be for the glory of the Lord. It all depends whether you are a vessel filled with manna, or a vessel containing manna, or filled with filthiness, abomination. What is inside? So outside you are a golden vessel. But what that has filled you? That's a $1 million question. What's inside? Worldliness, showing off, filthiness, adultery, fornication. What's the purpose? My dear brother, my dear sister, whatever the ministry we are doing, we can do it in two different ways. For the glory of the Lord, or for the money, or for the name, for the fame. So it's a golden vessel containing manna in it. To save time, let me go to the third one. That's what we considered last week. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verses 20 and 21. But in a great house. In another place we understand that house is the church of God. In a great house, in a church of God, in a local church. In a local church like this. There are not only vessels of gold and of silver, but also of wood and of earth. And some to honor and some to dishonor. If a girl therefore, purges himself or herself from these. From what? There are golden vessels filled with abominations. There are vessels to dishonor. There are vessels filled with rebellion. There are vessels filled with fornication. There are vessels filled with adultery. There are vessels filled with filthiness. Always they love to talk something filthy. I mean, I'm not standing here to criticize the believers. Even among the servants of God. Some of you senior believers, those who have got an accessibility with others, you know about many things more than what I know. One day I heard about three people. Those who are serving God, they are pastoring churches. It's only to make you understand there are vessels and to dishonor. I was told, Monday they could meet together, the only thing they would talk. Netava vandala, netiva vandala. That's all they could talk. Vessels unto dishonor, filled with filthiness. Sometimes the vessels filled with rebellion. Pastor Ganadari. Sun Kadagadi. Anna, youth meeting or sonna namapunma. Rebellion. Kulin, abdurna chapadangavana. Nitapatavella. Rebellion, spirit of rebellion. Konche wait panikonga. Alam ne, nin the chapati of the wait panama. Immediately retorting. Immediately. Vessels of rebellion, filled with rebellion. Vessels filled with adultery. The boyfriend and the girlfriend. Any time you talk about filthiness. They love it. They love it. Whether it's our pastors, our sisters, our boys, our girls, men or women. For some people, they are filled with talking about others. So there are different vessels in the same church. In the same church. But if you separate, the word is a very strong word. Purge. Adichi pudichi. Purging, I don't know how to put it in Tamil. Adipichi to order it. Chumma avulattu friendly. Okay, bye bye. Tata. Apdi solli to poradhal. The right way to understand, you are letting out without control. That's purging. That's really purging. When you want to come out of sin, you cannot say, oh, I'm sorry, please excuse me, I'll go. You cannot separate from sin like that. If you see a vessel of dishonor, purge out. Purge out. I remember once Pastor Sundaram said, you can allow anybody to house if you have got the guts to say, shut up, get out. Veetukulla yara vennalum allow pannunga. Eppo avanga edagilum deva namathukku mahimikku virodham edavadhu pesa aarambicha, shut up, get out. Avadi solla therinja allow pannunga, illana allow pannadhinga. When you see somebody filled with abomination, filled with adultery, filled with fornication, filled with rebellion, filled with worldliness, purge out. Here we see, if a man therefore purge himself from these, from the vessels unto dishonor, purge himself from these, he shall be a vessel unto honor. So third thing, a chosen vessel, a golden vessel with manna in it. This golden chosen vessel, golden vessel with manna in it, how can that become a vessel of honor when you know to purge yourself from these? If you want to be friendly with them, or you want to be very polite, not to disassociate yourself from these, You can never become a vessel unto honor. We can't be too decent with sin. You can't be too decent with sin. I mean, I'm telling you the Bible. If you want to become a vessel unto honor, you have to purge yourself from these. He shall be a vessel unto honor. Three things, sanctified and meet for master's use and prepare unto every good work. You are sanctified. You are set apart from that group that is unclean. There are Korah and his friends, those who rebelled against Moses, they are also Israelites. But Moses said, separate yourself from his team. Separate yourself from that team. It's for your own blessing, I'm telling you. If the Lord has to use you, not separate. A very strong word Paul says, purge out. As uncontrollably let out. Purge. As uncontrollably you let out. From these. Run away. Then number one, you are sanctified. You are set apart. You are holy. Number two, to meet for the master's use. God can use you the way that he has chosen. Maybe in the media. Maybe in the choir, maybe as a volunteer, maybe as a people helper. In some way the Lord can use you. For master's use, you'll be sanctified, you'll be for master's use. Maybe he can use in the Sunday school, he can use in the VBS. It's not that we are using you. We may make a mistake. It's not for our use, it's for God's use. God can use you in the Sunday school. God can use you in the VBS. God can use you as a pastor. God can use you as a missionary. God can use you as an evangelist. You are ready for master's use. So you are sanctified. You are ready for master's use. And number three, prepared for every good work. Prepared for every good work. I'm not just to segregate, but I tell you that some people are good for every good work. I can, even in a human way I say, we can trust them. We can trust them with finance. We can trust them with character. We can send that boy to any house, or we can send the girl to any house. We trust their character. We trust them with finance. We are using them in different ministries. We give them leadership platforms. Okay, we know they will not cross the bounds. In a human way, they are ready for any good work. In a spiritual way, the Lord is a master. The Lord says, they are ready for any good work. They are ready for any good work. Let me go quickly to number four. Now, chosen vessel. The chosen vessel is a golden vessel with manna in it. Now that golden vessel with manna in it is a vessel unto honor. That means it is sanctified. It is made ready for the master's use, prepared for any good work. Number four, 1 Corinthians 10:16. Make a note of it. 1 Corinthians 10:16. The cup of blessing which we use. This vessel has become a cup of blessing, a vessel of blessing. Aasirvadathin patra. I don't have time to explain. To save time, I just want to say one word. You become a vessel of blessing. A blessing to parents. A blessing to the church. A blessing to His kingdom. A blessing to the perishing world. There are some people, they are a pain to their parents. They are a pain to the parents. There's an English expression, pain on the neck. There are some people, they are a great burden, pain to the pastors. Different churches. Again, I love to quote our pastor Sundaramaya. He has got one prayer. Because I pray with him personally. We both pray together. About some people, he will say this word, Andavare Thiruthumayya, Ilana Thorathumayya, Thiruthumayya, Ilana Thorathumayya, Vedana. They are pain. They are teachers. They will be scared of some students. Yo, ana enna paavanjana, ippudi onni en class la vandu vaachirukkude. Vera class ku poyiradha, vera school ku poyiradha. Ippudi onni enakku venuma. About one student, once one lecturer said, it's a privilege to teach that child. About a particular child, a lecturer, she was talking with me. When she was talking with me, that lecturer said, it's a privilege to teach that child. It's a privilege to teach that child. One father was sick. The lecturer of his son, he came to see the father. The father was sick. The lecturer told that father, sir, I have seen the behavior of your son in different situations. Unga paiyanude behavior paathirukken sir. Avanga appa eppadi iruparnu paaka vandhen sir. Appadiyum pillainga irukku. Unga paiyanude behavior paathirukken sir. Avanga appa eppadi iruparnu paaka vandhen sir. Children, hello? Unga lecturers oda solluvaangala? Solluvaanga, namma pillainga neraiya pera patti solluvaanga. Some children, they are a pain to their parents. One day one mother came and told, when it was in AC, Ya, veliya irukkira paiyan edha laarila adipattu chethurunga, I say the jeevan pannunga. Petta paiyan laarila adipattu chethuranum, I say the jeevan pannunga. Daily there is a fight between father and son, father and son. Father is going to hit him, or the son is going to hit the father, running, fighting. The mother told me, certainly, avan laarila adipattu saagalame, யாரோ ஒருத்தர் ஒருத்தரை கொண்டுட்டு அடுத்தவங்க ஜெயிலுக்கு போக போகிறாங்க. ரெண்டு பேரும் நான் இழக்க விரும்பலை. அட்லீஸ்ட் என் பையன் அடிபட்டு செத்துடட்டும். பெயின். யோ, இப்படி ஒரு பிலீவர் இல்லைன்னா நல்லா இருக்குமே. ஆண்டவரே, நான் எதுவும் தப்பு பண்ணிட்டேன்னா என்ன மணி ஆண்டவரே, இல்லைன்னா இந்த பிலீவரை திருத்தி எனக்கு கிருபதாரு, இல்லைன்னா துரத்திடும் ஆண்டவர். ஜெபிக்கிறாங்க. பட் வென் யூ பிகம் எ சோசன் வெஸல், வென் யூ பிகம் a vessel, a golden vessel, when you become a vessel of honor, everyone here Every boy, every girl, every brother, every sister, you should become a vessel of blessing. God called Abraham and said, I'll bless you and make you a blessing. Pray, Lord, bless me and make me a blessing. I should be a blessing to my parents. I should be a blessing to the church. I should be a blessing to the nation. I should be a blessing to my college. One person resigned his job and he was stepping out for the ministry. His personal records were seen. Three of his officers have written their confidential files. He is an asset to the institution. Three officers have written about one person. One not knowing to the other. Confidential report. He is an asset to the institution. I ask you, are you an asset to this church or a liability to the church? Are you an asset to your family or a liability to your family? To your parents, to your father, to your mother? Are you an asset? நீ ஒரு சொத்தா, உங்க அப்பாவுக்கு உங்க அம்மாவுக்கு உங்க குடும்பத்துக்கு நீ சொத்தா இருக்கிறியா? உங்க குடும்பத்துக்கு நீ வேதனையா இருக்க? ஒன்னால உங்க அம்மா அழுதுகிட்டு இருக்காங்க, ஒன்னால உங்க அப்பா கண்ணீர் விட்டுகிட்டு இருக்கிறாங்க, ஒன்னால உங்க அப்பா வேதனைப்படுறாங்க. சபிக்கப்பட்ட வாழ்க்கை, சபிக்கப்பட்ட வாழ்க்கை. You should become a vessel of blessing wherever you are. To your family, to your church, to your school, to your college, to your work spot. In your confidential file, in your work spot, they should write, he is an asset to this factory. He is an asset to this firm. He is an asset to this institution. The world can hate you for only one thing. That's why your testimony for Jesus. In all the other counts, you should become a vessel of blessing. So it's a vessel chosen, a golden vessel, a vessel unto honor, a vessel of blessing. That is the vessel. We read in 1 Corinthians 10:21, you cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of the devil. There are vessels in the hands of the devil. People drink of that also. They are vessels in the hands of the devil. Vessel of the devil. There are vessels, vessels of the Lord. You cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of the devils. You cannot be partakers of the Lord's table and of the table of devils. 1 Corinthians 11:27. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink the cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. It's not only I'm a golden vessel, not only a vessel unto honor, not only a chosen vessel, not only a vessel of blessing, I belong to the Lord. I belong to the Lord. I am a cup of the Lord. I am a vessel of the Lord. 100% He holds me. Not the devil holds me. Not the devil holds me. God holds me. God holds me. 100% I am in the hand of the Lord. The vessel of the Lord. Just I read one verse to you before I conclude. Numbers 1950. And every open vessel which has no covering bound upon it is unclean, defiled. Moodi katta padamal tharandirukkira yenda patramam thittayirukku. Moodi katta padamal tharandirukkira yenda padamal, golden vessel, vessel of blessing, vessel of the Lord, whatever it may be. If there is no covering. About the bride, we read in Songs of Solomon 4:12, a garden enclosed is my sister, my spouse, a spring shut up, a fountain sealed, adaikkapatta thottam. If there is no veli around you, if there is no enclosure, if you are not enclosed, there is no discipline, there is no control, you are defiled, you are unclean. there should be a cover. No, I don't want any cover. I don't want any discipline. I'll do what I want to do. You're unclean. You may be a golden vessel. You may be a chosen vessel. But you are unclean, you are defiled, because you don't want to have a cover. You don't want to come under discipline. The Spirit of the Lord has spoken to you. The blood of Jesus Christ has made you a vessel unto us. Shall we just pray?